Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Terra Tech. And on this episode, we are going to be messing around in the R&D test chamber. I have no doubt on the last episode, I got a gazillion replies, and I'm going to put a note in there letting you guys know that I figured it out. I'm an idiot. I'm definitely an idiot. I forgot that it was under the play button. It used to be under here as an option, and that's what all the videos from like a year ago, nobody's really shown since then how to get into the test chamber. So I'm going to name this video how to get into the test chamber for other idiots out there like me who couldn't figure it out. You just go to the play button and under here you start a new game, and then when you're in here, normally this will be it right here, story mode. But if you click the little arrow right here, there's the R&D test chamber as plain as day. I actually would prefer it to be in the options right at the very beginning because it's not really another playthrough. It's just a test chamber, but whatever, it works. So let's see, we can load from community, we can load tech, or we can start a new. Let's see what they got from the community. Twitter is required. Now we're not going to do that. Load tech. Okay, so these are some of the ones that I have saved that we could start with. Like Dim 1 is actually pretty good. I would like to perfect that at some time. That way I can just buy the entire thing. But for now, let's just go with start new and see what they got in here, because I'm kind of curious just to play around. Now, if you guys have a certain bot that you want me to build, definitely leave that down in the comment section, because we will go ahead and do that. Register for the official Terra Tech form. If you don't have full access to the Terra Tech form yet, go to the options screen and click the button to register for full form access. Maybe. I might do that a little bit in the future. Wow, you can see like flames on all the items kind of showing up at the exact same time. I like it. So let's go over here with... Oh, what is this? What is this? Are these the experimental pieces? They definitely look like pieces of the Death Star or something like that. What in the world? Okay, so these right here are the firework launchers, which we have seen already and are absolutely fantastic. These things are really, really cool. Let's see, what is this? The Scrap Magnet Mini. That sounds pretty sweet. We'll definitely check that out. The Experience HF Vibro Blade. Is that like a melee weapon? Might be an upgrade to like the drills or something like that, or maybe a diamond tipped thing like the other guys have on the geocore. Let's see, what about this scrap magnet? So it's the bigger version of the mini. It definitely probably pulls things in. Let's see, what about this resource radar? Now, you're not really going to get to see any resources in this this build when you're in the test chamber. However, I've gotten this little device before. Didn't work. Like, it's still in development, obviously. So that doesn't show you anything. Maybe now it does. That was like probably about 2 weeks ago when I picked that item up for the very first time. Let's see, the dynamo generator. No idea what that does. We'll be playing around with that here. I'm just gonna do a brief overview of some of the items we've never seen before, just to, you know, look at them, and then we're gonna go back and play with them. The large hover plate. Oh, I wonder if that gives you more lift than the smaller ones. It definitely looked like it would, because the smaller ones basically are just the hover plate itself, just this very, very small bottom piece of this device. And this one, it actually has like an entire floor panel and the devices and the hover plates, and the hover plates look bigger than they do on the smaller version. So that most likely will give you more lift and allow you to carry more weight. Now let's see, what, look at this one, the buzzsaw. Oh my god, this can look so wicked. We are definitely going to make like a Wally that came straight from a horror movie or something like that in the future with something like that. Let's see, the altimeter. Is that like a car's altimeter? I don't know. We'll be playing around with that again. Oh yes, yeah, oh baby. And I want to give a huge shout out to Mind of Chaos for allowing us to come in here and play around with the R&D stuff. This is going to be wicked. So if you have any suggestions, Mind of Chaos, let me know. Whatever you want built, we're definitely going to get to that here. The Venture speedometer. That could be interesting. You know what? I'm not going to go through each and every one of these because I want to play around with one. I want to check it out. So let's come over here and build something simple. Something, just to get our feet off the ground. And I'm thinking maybe the geocore. What is this? What in the world? Geocore picker tractor? Oh, wow. Okay. What about... We're going to stick with small for now. Let's see. Can we get maybe like four or five blocks just to get us going? I think four would probably be good. Maybe five, because we're going to need space to put some of this stuff on there. So let's go with these. Let's go into build mode real quick. And we'll stick this on the bottom just to kind of keep with tradition, because I like to be able to have my bot protected and off the ground. Three, let's go with two on each side to give us a nice room to work with stuff. And then we could throw a couple of these on the front if they will turn it for us. Now, somebody did let me know that you could change that zoom in stuff and the turning button on the scroll wheel in the option menu under camera. I went under camera and there's nothing in there. Nothing at all. So that's not true. Maybe it is on yours, it's definitely not on mine. Somebody also wanted me to show what my graphics are set at, and they're set at the highest they can possibly go. Depth of field should have been on, I don't know why it isn't. Gamma, and then draw distance as you know, the max that I can possibly go on that one. Fantastic again. You can't really go any better than fantastic, apparently. So we'll go ahead and save those options right there and resume. Now, I kind of wish I had thought this out, because I don't see any wheels anywhere near me. Let's see. We're going to put we'll put a couple of these wheels on there for now. They're not going to be the finished product. But if I don't have wheels, I can't move to those geocore ones over there, and I kind of want to go with geocore wheels again, mainly for the fact that I'm going to put some heavy stuff on here just to play around with it, and I want to make sure we have the power not to kind of get bogged down. Okay, there we go. Come on, you could do it. You could do it. No, well, maybe you can't. Maybe you're not good enough. There. Ah, come on. I'm getting stuck even in the R&D test chamber. I'm thinking maybe it's just me, guys. Maybe it's just my lack of building design. Let's see. We're going to go with smaller big wheels like these right here that aren't going to get too much in the way if they will attach properly. There we go. And we'll get rid of that. We'll do another one over here. Nice. Nice. Okay. And two more in the back if we can. I do kind of want to do some armor on some of these, because it's not something we really messed around with, just for the pure fact that it just gets in the way a lot of the time. It blocks your... Oh, wow, look how fast that thing goes. Oh, nice. I like it. I like it. Maybe it could go a little faster. It's actually kind of slow when you get going, but... All right, let's see. This is the speedometer, or the speedometer, if you want to call it that. Oh, 26 miles an hour? 28, 23? That's... definitely going to come in really handy on all our builds for, you know, the test chamber. It's going to let us know how fast we've been able to get this stuff up to. Oh, yes. What on earth are these? I'm getting so distracted. This is the worst for somebody with, like, OCD. You come in here and you're like, what? What is this? The Geocore fixed anchor. What does that even mean? Fixed anchor? I guess, oh, my God. It's the bigger version of the GSO ones. So you can put guns and things on there. That is going to be really, really cool. Oh, man, if I can only find that in the video, in the actual game, that's going to be epic right there. Now, what is this? The Geocore repairable? Yes, please. Can we try it? Oh, we don't have any batteries, though. We're going to have to put a battery on here. Let's put this on that side. And the battery here in the back, maybe a little bit over, actually. See, we didn't really do... We did five, so that's not going to be even. It's going to be a little off. What on earth is this? No strings for it. Error. Is this a wireless charger for Geocore? I think it is. I think it's a wireless charger for Geocore that... Oh, my God. So nuts. So nuts. Okay, we need some power. What on earth is this over here? Let me see. No strings for it. Oh, it allows you to buy things. That is pretty sweet. I like it. Oh, my God. I love the design on it, actually. That is really, really cool looking. I do wish that the... You know, of course, I'm always asking for more, but I do wish that the screen was constantly, like, scrolling with information on it just to give it that little extra something, that little oomph that kind of would set it apart from like almost any other game out there, because it, you know, you're going that extra mile. And of course, I can't blame you guys for not doing that just yet. GeoCore AI module. AI modules. What should we do with those, guys? I'm thinking that we should find some horrible little place to grind this stuff up into little pieces of like paste or something. And that is what I'm going to throw into it at the very beginning. I absolutely hate those AI modules. They suck. Suck so bad. Or at least I suck at using them. Let's see. Where is the, where's the power? I need some solar panel or so. Yeah, the solar panel generators. And I am completely missing them. It's going to take a little while to memorize where everything's at so I can get it to, you know, nice smooth and just kind of come in here and get things. I don't see the solar panels. How are we supposed to create energy and try out our shields if we don't have any solar panels? How can you have your desserts if you don't eat your pudding? I don't see it. I don't see it, guys. Oh, man. That sucks. I really wanted to mess around with that. I want to see how big that shield gets. It has to be in here. I'm just missing it is what it is. Let's make one last pass over it. I don't see it, but you know what we could do is move this out of the way, actually. And come over here and just buy it from this little device, because I bet you more than anything this thing has it. So let's look into the base pieces. Nope, not there. Not there. Ah, there we go. Let's go ahead and buy one of those suckers. Nice. All right, and we'll attach that to the ground. Actually, we're probably going to need a few of these. So let's attach a few of these to it. We'll put batteries on them and see if that makes a difference. Although I can't believe these weren't actually in that that little area. Let's see. We're going to put a battery right there. Will it not charge the battery? Or is it charging the battery? I think it might be. Yeah, it's charging the battery. Okay, so we'll attach a few of those just to get that going. And then we'll put this on there. Oh, yeah. That's working. We'll keep going with that. Man, can you imagine an entire wall like this? That would just be nuts. All right, so I'm going to put some more batteries up on the top. Holy crap. Oh, wow. Wow, guys. Dang, that is huge. This bot is already pretty big. I mean, he's about medium size. And look at that. That is nuts. Absolutely fantastic. I love it. So we got the repair bubble from over here. Do they have a shield bubble as well? Is that a thing? I don't know, but we're definitely going to find out. Let's see. What else do you guys got? Anything? What is this? This is the... this is that, isn't it? Yes, it is. Somehow he got off the line, and now he's going to be trolling me. He's going to find some way to come over here and bash me from behind, I think. All right, let's see. What else do we have? So there's no shield one for the GeoCore. That's interesting. I kind of like that. I kind of like how you might have to have the repair bubble from the GeoCore and then like the shield one from one of the other ones. And I think the shield one actually is from over here. So let's look at the venture and see what else they have. Because I know this right here is the shield. Actually, no, it's the gyro stabilizer. And that's what we should be using for airplanes. Oh my God, we can do so many things with airplanes on here. We're definitely going to experiment with that. The Venture AI module, no thank you. Let's see, Venture remote charger. That's just like the other thing, right? Yeah, just a wireless charger. Yeah, we probably don't need that then. Although you may not even need the big one, really. I mean, why would you even want that on your bot, to be honest? Unless you were charging up a wall or something. So we can take that off. We don't really need that on there at the moment. What else do we have? The Venture radar. Venture radar, really? What does the Venture radar do? Is it better than a normal radar? I don't know. It might have a bigger radius, but you won't really be able to tell in here until later on. Venture shield bubble, guys. Venture shield bubbles. Let's put that on. What happened to the... oh, there it is. I was going to say, what happened to the green bubble? It's so big that when you're inside of it, you don't even realize you're inside of it. You can't even see it. Just the whole screen is hued with a little green to it. Wow, look at that, guys. The blue is the Venture one, and that one is enormous. That one is enormous compared to the other ones. And then when you look at the other one, it just pales in comparison. That is just, you know what, that actually might be a problem. Because any bot that you're fighting that gets within this range of the healing will get healed from that. Which means unless your bot takes up that entire space, maybe that would be a bad thing. Like, you're not going to want this one on just like any bot. You're only going to want it on the big ones. And you're only going to want it like in the center. And then on the outskirts, you might actually have to go with something smaller just to maintain that that radius the way you want it. So that's kind of interesting. I don't know. That might be kind of fun to play around with. Let's see. Landing gear will. That is kind of cool. What else do we got? A repair bubble. Okay, so we haven't seen the repair bubble yet. I haven't really played around with that one. So let's see how big that is. About the same size. Actually, it's a little bit larger. See, it's sitting right on top of the other one. So it should be the exact same size. It seems like it's just a little... Actually, it might be... Yeah, I think it's probably perfectly the same size. It's just that it was sitting on top, so it was a little higher. Now it's off to the right. That's not too bad. That's really not too bad, actually, guys. Let's see, what else do we got? Ooh, battery? Oh, we got a Venture battery. That's interesting. That's something we can play around with. Venture tractor pad. Are you kidding me? A tractor pad for Venture? Like, why would you want one? Venture is about speed. Maybe that's why it's so small. What if we, let's back it up and see if it will pick up any of this stuff over here while it's getting charged. No? No, it didn't. It seems like it wants to, though. Look at that. You can see it kind of shaking. I got it there. What if we put it on top? Will it do it? Okay, so got's one. Or it has one. Got's one. Got's it. I guess all is that all it carries? Just one? I think so. That might be it. Huh. So not a whole lot of power to that, unfortunately. Not a whole lot of... Venture. Like, why would you want to have a whole lot of stuff on your guy if you didn't need it? Let's see, what else do we have over here? What is this? Venture pod cab. Now, this is one of the things we've never really messed around with, is the different cabs. Because they're not easy to find. You actually have to find those in the world. As far as I've been able to figure out, you can't really make them. If you can, I've never found the recipe for them. So, unless you find those in the world, you're just not going to get access to those. Let's see, I think we did all of those things, yeah. We have found this weapon, the Venture Pip Machine, but it's not very good. Like, you can see right there, it doesn't fire very far. It doesn't seem like it has a lot of strength to it, and the accuracy is kind of all over the place if you look at it like that. Now, I've only ever had one of them. Maybe if you have an entire, you know, row of them, that it will come in handy, or... If it's really lightweight, but it doesn't tell you that stuff anymore. And you guys were letting me know that's a bug. They definitely will be bringing back the descriptions and things of that sort in the game at a later date. But for now, the items, they don't have the description on there. They don't. They never told you what the weight was anyways. A zoomer will. Well, we're going to be playing around with that. I'm going to make a fast bot, I think, on the next video. What else do we got in here? But yeah, it'd be nice if it told you the weight, at least in the R&D, you know, like that's the extra thing, that's the going above and beyond. What in the world is this? Avenger Reaper X1 Flaw. Well, you know what, Flaw? Come on, Coleslaw. We'll get you in there. We're gonna get you in there somehow. Doesn't really want to let me move, but I'm gonna get you on the front of my bot. All right, let's see what this looks like. Oh my God, it's a flamethrower. It's a flamethrower, guys. Oh, I'm in love. I'm in love with a flamethrower. Jeez. Look at that. And it even starts off slow. Starts off slow, and it gets further and further and further out. Oh, this is going on like all of my bots. I love... Oh, jeez. Big shout out to Mind of Chaos, man. Oh, my God, dude. You have no idea. This is fantastic. Oh, man. Unbelievable. I had no idea they had a freaking flamethrower in the game. That is sweet. All right, let's keep going. Ah, I can't believe we have so many things at our disposal here. All right, so they went ahead and put all the corner pieces in the corner. How clever of them. And most of them are sucky pieces that we probably never use, but they're there. You know, they're not bad, but I don't really use these things very much. They take up space, really. You know, the armor... And they don't really give you a lot for it. I would love to have it where you could have weapons firing through the armor, like maybe little slits that you could put like one or two very specific weapons behind it that maybe aren't even the strongest weapon out there. So you can kind of have, you know, an offset of more defense, but still that little bit of offense, you know, like it's still coming through. But when it's just pure defense, it doesn't really seem to kind of even out, and it's too much weight for like the airplanes and things of that sort. So usually I never kind of go down that path, but maybe one of you guys out there have a, you know, a unique design idea that you want to see me do in that. Now, let's see, we got some fuel tanks. We're going to be playing around with those fuel tanks for sure. We got the big boy guns, got every single type of gun out here, and we've seen all of these. Now we've been going through a lot. Actually, we found a new wheel here. Have not seen this one right here. The GSO riser wheel. So you can put that underneath and it kind of pops your bot up a little bit. That's kind of interesting. Can we turn it? Sure can. Or you can have it on the inside. Oh, I kind of like that actually. Put it on the inside of your bot, turn the other way. Nice. That will come in handy. That way you don't have to get stuck in the middle of your bot anymore, and yet you don't have to worry about those small ones that don't seem to have the give and take. Like this one seems like it already has a, you know, that little mechanism in there for it to kind of go over heels and give and take it a little bit, the stabilizer kind of thing in there, but maybe not. I don't know. Either way, that does look pretty cool, and I could see us doing some builds with that. Now, the one I'm kind of curious about is this little tractor pad right here. This GeoCore picker tractor pad. No idea what it means by picker, because it's so small. So small. Are we going to be able to pick stuff up with it? You can see it kind of moving it, but it doesn't seem to want to pick it up. Okay, so you can carry those. How many can you carry? Let's see if we can figure out what is the limit on these things. So 4, 5, 6. Okay, we'll come over here and we'll get a few more items, things that we might use in the future, like these wheels. That way we don't have just junk laying all over the floor. 6, actually no, you're gonna be put on there apparently. Let's go with 6. Let's keep going. 7, yep, 7 on there. How many can you hold? How many? 8? Wow, you're holding a lot. 9? Oh man. 10 I think would probably be its max. Okay, so there's 10. Let's keep going. Wow. Jeez, you're talking about some strength on this thing. Oh man. Okay, so we're up to what, 11, 12? I think it's 12. 13? Oh man. You can't tell me it's going to go up to 20. This is going to be 15. Maybe it might. It might go up to 20. Or maybe it's because we're in R&D that it's just continuing to go. I don't think that's the case. I think if it can only hold one, it only holds one. Yeah, see, it won't let me put anything more on there. So that was it right there. That is the extent of how much it can hold. That was, what, 15, 16? Somewhere around there. And that's pretty nuts. Let's back this up a little bit, and that way when we take that off, it all falls back here, out of my way. That way it's not in the way of any of our builds that we're doing up here. Let's see. Okay, we do have the geothermal what? It doesn't really say. It's too far, too long of a title. But I'm guessing that's just the cab, right? It's just a cab. Can we click on it? No, actually, I think that might be something else. A GeoCore geothermal. Oh, is that the one that makes power? I think it is. Let's put it down, and we'll get a battery and connect it to it, and we'll see if it starts actually generating power for it. How can we tell? We'll have to put it up a little higher, actually. And what if we remove that? No, that didn't work at all. GeoCore geothermal what? Geothermal what? Do you have to put it in the right spot maybe on the map? Right? Like that might be a thing. Let me go back to it and read the description. Oh, it doesn't have a description, does it? Nope, it does not. I don't know. This geothermal something. If you guys know how that works or what that does, I'll probably have to look it up on the webpage just to make sure, but definitely something we should play around with if it actually creates energy. Let's see, what is this? The plasma cutter. Plasma cutter. I think we've seen that before, haven't we? Oh, yes. Look at that. That is wicked. Okay, let's see if we can destroy this block. It's getting repaired as we damage it. That's what I was worried about, guys. Look at that. It's getting repaired by our own power. I don't know if we could destroy that, but when it blows, it should do a nice little explosion. You know, something I never paid attention to that you might have to let me know if you've seen this actually happen to you guys. When a battery explodes, does it explode more when it's fully charged than when it has no power left in it? Because usually if a battery is exploding, it's because your shields are down. That means it has no power, and that's how I usually see it. But some of you may get hit with like the big boy guns, and that would show you a bigger explosion if it was fully charged. But again, I've never really paid attention to that, so I couldn't tell you one way or the other. There's too much stuff in my way. This is what I was trying to avoid. Let's put this down over here and that over there, and we will go by this little area. I need to put some boosters on this thing because it's getting a little slow. 21, 27 miles an hour. Not necessarily the fastest out there. And what is this? Do they got some bases set up for us? I think they do. What exactly is in the center here? Okay, I see what that was. Well, why did I mess with it then? Okay, so they got a nice little base set up over here where you have your little stuff that can go through the way it should. What is this? I guess these are just, you know, they're giving you suggestions, little tips on how to do it. Oh, nice. Look at that. Those are the steps. Step conveyors. And one of you gave me the recipe for those, and I definitely will have to make some of those here in the future. But it's going around a what? What is this? What exactly is that? Can I put it on my bot and see? A medium generator. A medium generator. What is a medium generator? Oh, does that take fuel and convert it into like wood and convert it into energy maybe? I don't know. Either way, we're going to be playing around with it. All right, so this one can charge up. So they already had one out here. Here's the solar generator. I knew they had to have one here. I wonder why it's all the way out here, though. Let's see. Okay, so that is pretty basic right there. And then you got the recycler. Oh, check it out. And you got all the different resources that you can possibly have out here. So you can play around with the recipes and see what they take and how you can refine them into different materials. This one right here, this gray one, that one actually happens to be pretty much the most useful one in the game. If you want to pretty much build anything in this game, you're going to need a lot of that stuff. The other stuff definitely comes into play, but that one is going to be used the most. And then let's take a look at the different stuff. Like, they got plenty of room to just kind of run out there where there's nothing at all. But then you got a few ramps out here. My guy's totally not going to make that jump. If anything, he's going to flip over and go the wrong way. Oh, there he goes. He made it. He did take a little bit of damage, though. Something that shouldn't really be an issue with this giant freaking repair dome around me, which actually is going to cause some issues. And then you got your nice little bumpy ride over here. This is going to be hard for smaller bots. This will be the test, if you can get over these little hills. And you can actually see that some of these wheels underneath, like this one right here, it sparks because it's the only one holding the weight when it goes over these things. But that's still kind of cool. If you had enough of them over here. Oh, is that the Achilles heel right there? This is it. So you can figure it out. Like, what is going to make your bot not work? And there you go. It still doesn't work. This is a pretty bad design right here. Let's see if we can pop it up. No, we don't have any boosters on here, so it's not really helping us out. What is it stuck on? Can we reverse it? No, it doesn't. There we go. Let's get out of this thing. Yes. Yeah, we didn't design this guy to be perfect, but just kind of be our experimental, what is this little device? What does that thing do? Yeah, this is exactly what this guy's designed for. And then this, I don't, is it like, if your guy's too big, he can't fit in here? Is that what that's for? Or is it more for like agility, where you're just trying to see how fast you can make turns and avoid? Because this guy makes turns so quickly. Look at that. Look at that. That's amazing on his turn radius. That's just, yeah, it's nuts, guys. Nucking the fucks. Oh man, we're gonna be able to get up this just fine with the geo core. That is it's the way to do it. It's the way to do it, guys. Oh, so we're supposed to be going this way? I think so. I think this is it. This is gonna be a bumpy ride. I don't know if I really wanna. You know what they really need is stabilizers, something where one wheel can go up on this side and the other wheel stay down on the other side. You know, they have that in cars, so you don't get that rockiness right there. They don't really have it in this one just yet. It's maybe more advanced than what they're trying to do, so we'll have to see how that works out. But they got a nice little, you know, obstacle course out here. This is going to be cool to play around with for sure, guys. I really want to do a fast... Oh my god, why do I always find like the one spot that my bot is not able to go down, and then I'm just like, I'm going down that way. That's just, you know, how I'm going to do it. I am like a programmer's worst nightmare. I go in places, they are like, why did you do that? I never programmed that because nobody would do that. And, you know, you have a nice size bot and I'm like, ah, it's cool, right? It works perfectly. And then I get a hold of it. I'm like, 2 seconds later, I'm stuck. So, yeah, you know, doesn't you know, it's what it is. But guys, I do want to thank you all for joining me. Hopefully you have enjoyed this little walkthrough, this little, you know, I don't even like tour of what the R&D has to offer. Now, of course, we are probably for the next 4 or 5, maybe even more episodes, going to be making items in here. Just, you know, curiously going through and creating a venture bot, you know, the fastest one that I can design. I'm going to be messing with the wings on a bot so that he stays further down. From what I'm told, if you use these like stabilizing ones in the back, these spoilers, but you turn them, you know, upside down, you actually force the bot to, you know, push, you know, down onto the ground so he doesn't take off. And if he's really, really fast, that's what you kind of need. You know, the NASCAR, you know, they do the exact same thing as well. So that's going to be, I think, the next bot that I do is going to be a fast, you know, venture bot with the shields and the stabilizers and this this little gyro mechanism right over there. Maybe trying to do, oh, you know what, something we didn't put on here at all were these things. Let's try this out before we end it and see what happens. Oh yeah, look at that. That is cool. This is gonna get messy here in a second, but we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. Come on, let's see. Oh wow, it picks up some big items too. Big items. Can we pick up the battery? Come on, pick it up. You know you want to. No, it doesn't want to pick up the battery. How about over here? Let's see how messy this gets. This can get real messy actually. Oh, it knocked the other one off, so it can only carry so many items. It knocked another one off. Yeah, that's the limit right there, guys. That's the limit. Let's see how many is. That's one. Yeah, this is going to be a nightmare. Two. Oh, it's like flinging stuff. Holy crap. I don't know what's going on, guys. Three, four, five. Can we do it? Six, seven. I think it was probably 8 or 9. Was the whatever that happens, yeah, that's nuts. Okay, so 8 or 9, maybe 10 at most for this this thing to attract it. But I think the point of the magnet is to attract it, and then like your tractor pad or your hover pad or whatever to go ahead and take access of it after that. And then let's look at this. Let's put this on the front of our. Although on the side really kind of looks cool. You can create like a Warhammer bot or something with this thing. And, yeah, baby, who wants some? Flamethrower and knives, come on. How much better can you get than that? Actually, the flamethrower is perfectly fine all by itself. It doesn't really need the knife, but, you know, it's pretty sweet. And for those of you who may not have seen the last episode, let me go ahead and throw this on there real quick. This is our fireworks. Fireworks, guys, absolutely love it. I do kind of wish you could change the design and maybe the color. Would be very cool to have at your disposal. But again, you know, I ask for the moon all the time. So we'll have to keep that in mind. Let's see. Experimental what? Experimental dynamo generator. How do you do... What does the dynamo generator do? Does it create electricity? Let's watch our power here. Oh my god. It actually is creating electricity. Our power is going up instead of down. How does that work? It just randomly creates electricity all the time. Like, that's not overpowered. Like, that, no wonder it's in experimental. This would, like, you would never, ever have to do anything else. Why would you need solar panels? No, there, the power stopped. Only when I'm moving, maybe? Let's see if we move around. Oh, yes. It goes up as you move around, so it's going to be worthless for bases. But for a bot that's constantly going around, such as a, you know, a drone that you created, or one that you're driving yourself, the more you move, the better off you're going to be. That is really cool. I like that. Maybe way too powerful, but still at the same time, very useful for sure. Let's see, what else do we got? The altimeter. Let's put that on there. Oh, and it shows us our elevation. That's we're definitely gonna put that and the miles per hour thing on each and every one of the bots we create. And you know, I'm thinking of maybe doing something like a Gears of War type buzzsaw fire and you know, look at that, we got sparks of lightning going straight up and oh my god, this just looks nasty. It's not even done yet. Like, this is just the experimental bot, and he already looks like something. If I saw out there, I would just turn and run in the other direction with this guy doing what he's doing. That is, no, thank you, please. Let's try these underneath. Let's go underneath, and we're gonna put a few of these guys down and just see how well they work. Probably a little too well. This is gonna, you know, put me off of the ground, and I won't even be able to touch it with my wheels. Let's see, come on, one more? Yeah, we can put one more. Now let's put it down. What if we do a jump? Actually, we don't have any speed boosters. Let's put a couple of boosters on here, and just to kind of play around with that. Was there anything else? There is this thing right here, but that's not gonna do anything, right? Because there's... Oh, it shows the resources over there, right? What if I take that off? No? What if we get over here close to the resources with this not being on my bot? And I do realize I got a piece stuck right in front of me. Little troll dude. And then we'll put this on top. No, it still doesn't show the resources. We're walking right by. Not just the ones that are, actually blocks that you can mine, but the blocks that have already been mined, it doesn't show either. So I don't know how that's supposed to work. Or... like I said, it didn't work last time I got it in the game, so it still may be something they're working on that's just not quite done yet. And that's kind of unfortunate, because that would be really cool to play around with. Let's see, we're going to put some fuel tanks on this sucker. Yeah, we don't have to worry about them exploding, so, you know, that's not a thing. We'll put these things up a little bit more. That way we can put the boosters on the back. Oh, yeah. Yeah, baby. Let's do one more booster somewhere. And let's push it, guys. it doesn't turn very well, but what is this? What is this? A GSO static what? GSO static furnace gin. I don't know what that means. It's definitely part of the base stuff. We'll have to do a base as well. And of course, I will save this stuff by taking pictures of it as we build things that I actually want to save. This one I would save just for the pure fact that I'd like to be able to use any of these items later down the road. But you actually have to get the items before you can purchase them, even if they are a build that you've done before. So let's push it. Oh, wow, that didn't work. All right, let's push it now. 60, that wasn't too bad. Does it show us what our max is, though? What in the... Oh, you know, it exploded. It took some damage. Oh, look at our knife fell off. Yeah, it doesn't like running into things at 60 miles an hour. What's wrong with it, man? You should love going into things 60 miles an hour. Oh, man. That... Even on these little things, it just doesn't like my builds. They just don't like it. They don't like it, guys. We are going over it, though. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Oh, maybe not. Maybe it can't do it. I don't know. But we're definitely going to be playing around with this on the next episode, guys. Again, I'm AC Gamer, and I'll catch you all next time. Hey, guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.